Good morning, my vibrations. It's V to the I to the B to the mother of 5E. And today is Kai's birthday party, so let's get right into it. The 59th verse of Change Your Thoughts, Change Your Life by Dr. Wayne Dyer is living by thrift and moderation. In governing people and serving nature, nothing surpasses thrift and moderation. Restraint begins with giving up one's own ideas. This depends on virtue rather than the past. If there is a good store of virtue, then nothing is impossible. If nothing is impossible, then there are no limits. If a man knows no limits, he is fit to lead. This is the way to be deeply rooted and firmly planted in the Tao, the secret of long life and lasting vision. There are four words that crop up repeatedly in many of the translations of this passage of the Tao Te Ching: restraint, frugality, moderation, and thrift. Here, Lao Tzu is advising you to examine the way you look at these qualities in relation to your supervisory and parenting roles. He doesn't say that you should sit on the sidelines and do nothing, but he does counsel you to practice self-control. When you cultivate a style of leadership that creates a good store of virtue, then nothing is impossible, for there are no limits. Living in thrift and moderation means being in harmony with the world through your generous nature, rather than continually prodding, directing, giving orders, settling down rules, and demanding obedience. It's important to be a leader who accumulates a warehouse full of virtue by living in accordance with the Tao. When that's what you have to give away, you'll naturally interfere less. Feel joyful knowing that the example you're modeling is helping others make the right choices, as this is the essence of Tao leadership. As Lao Tzu specifically states, if a man knows no limits, he is fit to lead. People whose lives are run by rules, dogma, and fear can only do what they've been told to do, nothing more. The options for self-direction are non-existent for the blindly obedient. So practice restraint, moderation, frugality, and thrift when making pronouncements about how others must behave. Children raised in families where the blind obedience is demanded have the highest levels of prejudice when they become adults. Why? Because they've been taught to prejudge what's acceptable according to someone in a position to lead them. That's why it's so vital to give your kids an example of leadership that encourages them to make choices based on higher standards. I have a gift from my daughter, Sage, that I've placed on my desk, which I've titled Nothing is Impossible. It's a green plant growing out of a rock. There's no dirt or earth, only hard rock. Yet it thrives, despite what all of us have been taught to believe. When Sage gave this to me, she remarked that it reminded her of me because I've always said that I refuse to believe in anything being impossible. My plant helps me remember that nature knows no limits and that I am as much a part of nature as both the rock and the greenery growing within that hard stone. Lao Tzu reminds you that if nothing is impossible, then there are no limits. So practice living without limits by gathering virtue and modeling it. When you do, you'll see the lasting vision in those you've been selected to lead in one way or another, and they'll see it in you too, and put the wisdom of this 59th verse to work for you by taking these suggestions. Gather as much virtue as you possibly can. For years, I practiced gathering virtue without realizing it. I sent hundreds of thousands of books to individuals and organizations at my own expense, getting into the habit of beginning each day with this act of love. I spent a great deal of time giving away much of what I earned, almost all of it anonymously. I didn't write it at the time, but what I was doing was accumulating virtue, or what I facetiously called God points. I then found that not all of my life was to be peaks and mountaintops. Yet when I succeeded in getting out from under what felt like a mountain, I was virtually unscathed. This is because I was so deeply rooted and firmly planted in the Tao that my original vision was to be a lasting one, impervious to external circumstances. Practice moderating your ego. Change the way you look at your life by moderating your ego. See yourself as a being who gives rather than collects, and live on what you need rather than practicing conspicuous consumption. You'll begin to see that your purpose has more to do with Tao consciousness than ego directives. When you moderate your demands and use only what you and your family require, you'll gather virtue points by serving rather than accumulating. Lao Tzu reminds you that this is the secret of a long life and lasting vision. William Shakespeare described this more than 2,000 years after Lao Tzu's passing in his play, The Third Part of Henry VI. My crown is my heart, not my head, not decked with diamonds and Indian stones, nor to be seen. My crown is called content. A crown is it is that seldom kings enjoy. Here's Do the Tao Now. Make a commitment to gather 5 good points today. Imagine how the divine source of all 10,000 things must be operating in order to maintain the creation cycles of life. And do 5 things that match up to it. Pick up a piece of someone else's trash, which is an example of excess. Anonymously give a gift to someone in need, or perform any other actions that help you accumulate virtue and remain deeply rooted in the Tao. And there you go. As always, the Do the Tao Now is in the description. And if you see this video before 4 o'clock, you are welcome to come by and join us for this party. DM me for the address, because I'm not going to put it on here. So, see ya.